everybody. So that just cropped me up. Super weird. I was not expecting that to happen so much. Okay. Okay, weird angle. I am sorry. And actually, I have two cameras going on now. Because of how my last video messed up, I just want to make sure that I actually do capture a video. So that when I do this unboxing, you actually do see the full unboxing, like my full reaction, when I had that reaction, etc., etc., my full thoughts, whatever. Anyway, so gonna go ahead and get started, cause I feel like this box came a little bit earlier than normal. I feel like I normally get it around the 10th-ish or so, and it is like the 5th of February. I could be completely wrong, but I am super excited, so I really have to open up this box now. Anyways, so if you've been to my channel before, then you're familiar that I get a monthly subscription from what is now known as the Witch's Moon. Before, it was known as the Moon Box, but they now have this new name, same company, and it is wonderful. So it's a subscription box for anybody that is spiritual, anybody that is into the witchy things, you know, natural things, herbs, candles, incense, things of that nature. I totally opened this up upside down. I don't know why. My bad. Sometimes, you know, you do things that you can't explain. Anywho. Okay, so for anybody, if I do not end up uploading this version, if I upload the version that is through the camera, which actually has worse lighting right now, I'm sorry, but if I upload this stuff from this camera, yes, this painting behind me has a little bit of nip, but it's art. It's classical art. It's a painting. Well, technically it's a drawing. I'm sorry. And my friend drew this, actually, another witch. He's a really good artist. So, going back, here it is, the Witch's Moon, after opening up the first ugly box, you know. Alright, this one. Totally have this shit upside down and around. I don't know where I am. Oh, ooh. So, opening up, we are greeted with this oracle card. And it is so oh, now I know what it is. It kind of took me a while. All I saw was red and I was confused. But let's take a better look at that card. And it says, "The Phoenix will rise. You are not permitted to enter into the divine fire of personal transformation unless you are capable and worthy of the challenge. The reward bestoweth on the other side of the journey is such that all suffering throughout is redeemed. No matter what struggle you have endured, you shall rise again. This is your destiny." Alright. And then saving these off to the side for later. Ooh, that's so pretty. So, ooh, it's so blue. Okay, so first, the we have this little Book of Shadows artwork that is just gorgeous. And it says Ostara, and it is for the Sabbath Ostara, which Ostara is a modern invention taken from a 8th century reference, then adapted into 19th century folklore and further transformed into the celebration of vernal equinox as the 8th and last Sabbath to be initiated into Gardner's Wicked Chronicle Wheel of the Year. Do 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 do. It is from the 20th to the 21st of March, and it's kind of it's also spring equinox. It's kind of similar to Easter, you know. I would go more into it, but unfortunately, I'm not going to. Gonna have this up closer in case you want to attempt to screenshot that and read it, but I highly doubt it will be legible on here. I will have another link to my Tumblr, and I will have the name of my Amanio so that then you guys can go ahead and look at that and get the correct images from there. All right, now I got super excited because everything is blue. I'm blue, da-me-da-me-da-me. There you go. I love the color blue, so it's really pretty. Like, I can't even explain the color blue tissue that they have. It's gorgeous. Okay, so then we got a lovely little bubble wrap. And after that, pushing it away, like, you have this kind of a dark blue, not really navy blue. It's a royal blue. There we go. So we have royal blue tissue and then sky blue frizzies in here. Let's just add to it. And then after the frizzies, as my hair is frizzy, I'm sorry. So, ooh. Why is it that every single time I'm about to go buy something, I end up picking it up inside this box every single fucking time? I love it. So, we have a little bag of chamomile within this box, and I shit you not, I have been meaning to go buy some fucking chamomile for a while. Like, fuck. Thank you. Thank you. Oh my god. Okay, next herb up. Is actually eucalyptus leaf. There you go, if you can see the pretty writing. The little bunches of that. Then I'm gonna have to. Lady. Okay, I'm gonna assume that this is Lady. Lady Menon? Lady something or another? It's kind of difficult for me to tell. It's gonna be difficult for you guys to tell because it's blurry beyond fuck. And on that camera, you can't see shit. But I'll be able to read it once I go back and actually read the paper because I'm sorry. The handwriting's too pretty. I don't know. I don't know. Anyhow, okay. So then we have this little box, and within this little box, we have some fake moss, and we have a necklace. Ooh, that is gorgeous. So that looks like a deer. I really wish this would focus. But that looks like a deer over a triple goddess moon. And along with being over a triple goddess moon, it has a little sun at the bottom. That is just gorgeous. As I said, with fake moss behind, and it has a lovely not chain, but it's like a rope necklace. Ooh. Now I'm gonna shut this because this fake moss is starting to go places all over the floor, and I don't really want to pick that up. Like, I'm gonna have to. I'm gonna have to. I need to vacuum my floor anyway, but. Oh, that's so pretty. I think that's a dome. I could be wrong. It could be a hair. But I think it's a dome. Anywho, okay. So, now. Picking up this little bundle of something. Oh, ooh. I have no idea, but it smells good. as everything does. I have no idea what this little bundle is, but we shall find out later. Anywho, next item up is the salt. And this salt is... I cannot really read the swirly. Aliel? Angel? I don't know. But it also has this lovely sigil right next to it with lots of hearts, lots of glory, lots of pretty. And inside, it smells delicious. Inside it looks like there is some... Yeah, it looks like there's some chamomile on top with some lavender. You can really smell the lavender. Boy, oh. Okay. Gotta put that down. Oh, I'll just be smelling that one. Okay. There are like a couple different bags in here. I am super excited. But, okay. Okay, so next up, I'm gonna have to open up this guy within the pretty little like periwinkle satin bag. It is heavy. But, ooh. And it isn't. Ooh, what is this? Look at this. This is a giant chunk of something. And it is gorgeous. Holy fucking shit. Ooh, beautiful, beautiful blue crystal. Ooh, and this just shut off. I don't know what this is just yet, but we shall find out later. Gotta put that back in the back. Ooh. There was like a little chunk of red something too. Like a little teeny, tiny little speck. Which, you know, red from on a crystal could be a lot of things too. It could not necessarily be like part of the crystal. But anywho, okay, and now we have some incense. And I just gotta smell you, see you smell. It smells delicious, whatever it is. Not like delicious, but it's a very nice clean scent. It might be eucalyptus. Maybe not. I'm just taking a guess. Since eucalyptus is like a clean smell and there's some eucalyptus in here, I'm taking a stretch here, okay? I'm sorry. Next up is this little plastic bag with some more bubble wrap, possibly containing our oil of the box of the month. Of the month of the box. Alright, and this Sanitam? I think I said that correctly. Sanitam. I have no idea. But it's filled to the brim with herbs. Possibly rosemary. But I have no idea. It smells. Smells great, a little stronger than their other oils. I really wish I knew what it was. Okay. Next. Is this little tissue wrap up, which I am assuming is our candle. So the spell candle of this month is a nice navy blue. And it says for the spell, the knot is a little bit harder, tighter. The knot is tighter than it normally is, so my bad. I just had to shimmy it off. Anyway. It says healing fight. Okay. So the spell, here's the candle. Pretty, pretty. Okay. So the spell is healing fight. I just want to make sure that I read that right, and it was healing fight, and not something else. Like healing fight? I don't know. There you go. And then finally, because we have to save this for last, just to make sure. All right, beautiful little navy satin bag, and inside is Oh, that is pretty. Inside is this little chalice with the triple goddess symbol on it, and just like some nice design work along the stem. That is gorgeous. I love it. That's pretty. Okay, so now that we have successfully gone through everything, let's go ahead and read this guy. Alright, so the box of this month is for healing and transformation. Alright, the beginnings of a new journey are on the horizon as we set into the new year. Ooh, I got really close. I'm sorry. As we set into the new year, we are revitalized with new energy, new ambitions, and a new purpose. We travel with a strong sense of curiosity and openness of the heart. During the month of February, we focus on healing ourselves and those around us through the power of transformation. Situations and setbacks are only but a stagnant mindset connected to the old thought patterns and negative feelings and energy. Being one with the universe means being a child of growth and possibility. We do not allow ourselves to be defined by our past, but our aspirations for a brighter future. We focus on healing spiritual wounds, transforming ourselves into the strong, beautiful beings that we are naturally created to be. We have been on a journey to create a box to give you a special, one-of-a-kind experience with healing and transformation. Join us as we maintain our persistence in gaining spiritual knowledge and power by using the tools available to us. Alright, the magical items in this box are chalice, one of the four elemental tools of ritual. Chalice, or calyx, has been used for hundreds of years as a powerful sacred tool. Representing water, most importantly, the womb of the goddess, the chalice assists us in receiving spiritual energy, giving offerings, and connecting with those around us and with the divine. Alright, and then the gem. So the gem is actually blue kyanite, one of the most powerful of the throat chopper stones. Blue kyanite has been one of our favorite crystals for creating a stronger, most potent aura. And then we have the celestial hair pendant. So it is a hare, not a deer. My bad. I thought it was a doe at first because it looked a little bit longer than a hare. My bad. Sorry. Anyway, so celestial hair pendant. We have been searching for this pendant for many in the renewal process. This candle has been enchanted with rosemary and eucalyptus essential oils. We have also included a special mixture of our healing magical oil from our personal cabinet of witchery. I can never see that quartz. Like, the lumineer in quartz is just so clear. It's really hard to see it inside oils, so I apologize. It is in the oil, though, because after you look around, like, more closely and you kind of like shake up the herbs a little bit, you can actually find it. It's really hard. Like, there's no way I could like point it out for you guys. No way. Alright, so next up is the Goddess Ejio Sacred Salt. We have enchanted the Sacred Salt with rosemary and sandalwood essential oils, as well as chamomile, blue cornfield, cornflower and lavender herb. We have also included a special mixture of our Golden Aura magical oil from our personal cabinet witchery. The next up is the small Sasha sage. Small Shasta sage from the sacred Mount Shasta in Northern California. Shasta, I don't know why I'm having such a difficult time with that word. I'm so sorry. The Shasta sage is usually found in smaller bundles as it lasts for a long time. Shasta sage is a great healing sage and is known for bringing healing energies as well as the spiritual strength. Shasta sage is also known for enhancing intuition and attracting abundance while you work to transform the energies in your aura and around your sacred space. Burn Shasta sage before and after ritual to prepare and attract the healing energies in your life. Alright, and then the next thing is enliven incense. The scent of eucalyptus. Oh, I was right for once on the incense. Ooh. Alright. The scent of eucalyptus has been used in many important magical practices. We love to use this scent as a tool to spiritually open ourselves to accepted blessings. Alright, and then next item is our eucalyptus leaf. And the leaves of eucalyptus plants has been long used in healing spells and sachets. Stuff a poppet with eucalyptus or carry with you to maintain vibrant health. To heal others, ring eucalyptus around a green candle and visualizing the person's becoming completely healthy and renewed. The leaf of eucalyptus is also great to burn in an offering bowl to prominent healing energies during ritual. Next up is the chamomile herb. When working to combat negative energies, curses, or spells, chamomile is our go-to herb. Sprinkle chamomile around your house to remove curses and spells that have been cast against you. Steep in teas and brews to relax and calm the nerves. And also it's good if you feel like you're gonna throw up, you know, a little bit of like an upset stomach. You can sip on some chamomile and it'll help calm you. Allow chamomile to rest you so that you may heal throughout the night. Chamomile is a great assister during sleep to maintain healthy dreams and relaxation through the night. Next up is the Lady Meadow herb. The Lady Meadow or Meadow Sweet has been proven to be a beautifully happy herb. The scent of the Meadow Sweet cheers the heart and brings peace into your space. Commonly used in love spells, Meadow Sweet is a great attractor of happiness and love. Allow Lady Meadow to your ritual to bring about the energies of healing and love so that your intentions may maintain purity. And then the last items is the personal oracle reading, the parchment paper, and the Ostera Book of Shadows artwork. The personalized oracle reading is a card from the Wild Kuen Yin by Tony Elena Fairchild oracle set. And then the Orisol Book of Shadows artwork is artwork done by Adriana Molden. Alright, and then the closing. As you perform your ritual, do not set expectations. Cast your intentions and be pure of heart and mind. These very powerful moments are for you. There is so much knowledge available to you. Take pleasure in knowing that you are becoming one with the earth, stars, and universe. Open yourself to receive these beautiful gifts. We urge you to stay curious and hungry for knowledge. We are set free by the beautiful world around us. We send you love and light as you dive into the comfort of the healing process and work towards your spiritual transformation. Blessed be the Witch's Moon. Alright, so that was that box for February. I hope you guys enjoyed watching, just as I enjoyed everything that I've received. And I hope you guys have a lovely day.